Hey guys, Dr. Kyle Loveless here. In this video, I'm gonna teach you about inflammation and the reason this is so important. We all know it's a big deal. We all know we wanna reduce it and everything else, but do we really know what it is? What is it? What is this thing we deal with, inflammation? Is it really that bad, or is it a good thing? Stay tuned, watch this video. Hey, make sure you subscribe to our channel and like this video if you have any feedback for us. If you wanna hear more about anything else, put it in the comment section. We'd love to hear from you. And here we go, we're gonna dive into this thing. Hey guys, let's talk inflammation. Dr. Kyle Loveless here again, and so we're diving into what is inflammation. I think it's so important. You know, when people want to get rid of something, I always ask them, well, do you even know what it is? Like, what is this inflammatory response that we're having? And the thing I'll tell you is that it is really linked to every healthcare issue we have, digestive health issues, anything that ends in itis is an inflammatory issue. Probably the number one selling medications on the market right now, whether it's in the drug stores or from your doctor, is some sort of anti-inflammatory drug. It's so rampant, it's crazy. And the thing is they have a lot of side effects. Few people know that ibuprofen, for instance, within the month that you take it, you have an increased 20% increased chance of having a heart attack within the month that you take it. My dad actually had a heart attack, and his doctor told him never to take ibuprofen because of that fact. So it's the truth, but people are taking it on a regular basis. But more importantly, why? Why do we feel inflamed? What is inflammation? And I want to teach you that right now. And so inflammation is actually an innate immune response. It is exactly what your body wants to do. Your body is made to heal. It is that, it's wonderfully, powerfully made. It doesn't need help healing. It just needs no interference. And so with that said, we need to figure out inflammation, okay? When you go to sleep, I'm gonna give you an example. When you go to sleep at night, okay, the questions that we ask are very important. So I'm gonna tell you a little setup here. When you go to sleep at night, your body is regenerating, right? You get some good sleep, cells are dying off, new cells are being replaced, regeneration, replication, cellular replication is happening. It's awesome, right? Okay, our body's healing. In that process, inflammation is occurring. And so when you wake up, you actually have become inflamed overnight. Your body, your adrenals release something called cortisol, right? Cortisol is very important, and even though it's gotten a bad rap, that cortisol is what makes us fat and everything else, and it's the stress hormone, it's actually very important because it's what wakes you up in the morning. So it gives you that kind of boost of energy. If you're waking up and you're exhausted still, it's because your adrenals aren't producing that cortisol. That's why you go for coffee to try to stimulate those adrenals. And then that cortisol converts to something called cortisone. And cortisone is it's our body's strongest natural anti-inflammatory. That's why they use it as a synthetic form to inject into joints to get rid of inflammation. So it's very strong. That's the process. So we wake up, cortisol wakes us up, turns to cortisone, deflames us, right? If you feel tired and inflamed in the morning, it's because your adrenals probably are having some issues working, right? Now, that process is natural and it's very effective. It's very important. When you sprain an ankle, all the blood flow goes there, immune cells go there, that inflammatory response happens, and it's there to heal you. We don't want to compress it and ice it and do all these other things and reduce that inflammatory response because that's healing. We want that to happen. And so those things are happening, and they're amazing. But then there's this concept of what they call chronic inflammation. And we're always trying to get rid of chronic inflammation. We want to take turmeric, which I think is a great herb or a great supplement. Or we're always trying to take an ibuprofen, something to get rid of chronic inflammation. And the reason that's just happening, the reason we're not getting anywhere with this is because the questions we're asking are wrong. You go to your doctor, and let's say you have ulcerative colitis. It's itis, right? Your colon is inflamed. The doctor is going to give you an anti-inflammatory because his question is, how do I get rid of inflammation? Well, that's easy. Take a drug that blocks the inflammatory response and you reduce inflammation. Problem is, his question should be this, right? And I go through this whole, not just teaching what inflammation is, but how do you get rid of it? How do you know if you're inflamed? I have a whole ebook on this whole process, but I want to teach you what it is today, okay? And so the question, instead of saying why or how do you get rid of inflammation, the question is, why is your body creating a constant immune response? So think about that. Inflammation is just an immune response. Right? A virus comes in, it creates an inflammatory response to get rid of that protein. So your body's creating a constant immune response. That means it's constantly working if you have high levels of inflammation. So our question is why? We need to start looking at why. And the why always goes back to some sort of stressor in your environment. It could be a physical stressor, like you had a car accident or injury, or maybe you're overworking out, you're exercising way too much. Maybe you sleep wrong. Maybe, I don't know, you're on a computer all day long and you're physically stressed. Or it could be a chemical stress. Maybe you live in a moldy environment, right? Maybe you just got, you're taking a bunch of medications that are chemically toxic, which is very common. It's the most common toxicity in our country right now is medications. Or maybe it's an emotional stress, which is what we all think about with stress. Like maybe it's money, maybe it's time, maybe it's family members or something like that. But that stressor is what's gonna engage that immune response, right? Maybe it's a bacterial issue in the gut. Maybe it's a yeast issue in the gut. Whatever it is, the goal to get rid of inflammation is to say, okay, why is my body creating a constant immune response? And then you start investigating. You start looking at the stressors in your environment and reducing what you can. You start testing to see, is there any other stressors in my body? You do x-rays of your spine, see if there's degenerative changes, see if it's out of alignment. And that's why chiropractic care is so good for this. But you ultimately want to find out why you're inflamed. And once you figure it out why, or you start moving in that process and start taking things to get rid of those stressors, that's where you actually get healthy. Not getting rid of inflammation, it's getting your body to not want to create a constant immune response. Because all we're doing with this medication to get rid of inflammation is blocking your body's immune response, and your body is creating that immune response because there's something it's trying to get rid of or a stressor it's trying to survive through. Y'all follow me there? So it's a different perspective. We have to look at it differently instead of saying, how do I get rid of it? Why am I inflamed? If you want to figure out if you are inflamed or what you can do to start to reduce that inflammatory response and correct the problem in your body, go into the links below, grab my ebook. I actually just put a 16-page ebook together. It gives you 10 things to tell you if you are inflamed, 10 things you can do about it, and then it even gives you stuff after that if for some reason that's not enough for you on how do you do the testing and everything else. It's awesome. You're gonna love it. So go down there, hit that link, and that'll actually take you to the ebook and tell you a ton about your health. And hey, it's free. Why not? All right. Hey, you guys have an awesome day. I hope that was informative and I hope it gave you a different perspective in saying, not how do I get rid of inflammation, but why is my body creating this constant immune response? Hey guys, thanks again for watching our videos. If you want to learn more about your health, if you really want to become your own health expert, I want to show you how. We have actually created online courses for you to continue to learn about becoming your own health expert. Our most recent one that we're launching is How Do You Raise a Healthy Family? This one's big. I get questions all the time about this. And I'm going to teach you how to eat. What should your whole family be eating? And how do you individualize that for your family? What supplements should you be taking? How do you detox your family? How do you detox your environment? Get these chemicals out. How do you deal with all these things, right? How do you deal with fevers and ear infections and constipation and diarrhea? How do you create a natural medicine cabinet, right? Also, I'm gonna hit on vaccines. I'm gonna talk about the thing that so many people are nervous about but don't know if it's good, don't know if it's bad, don't know what to do. And I'm gonna be very clear and tell you the science behind it all. This is very simple, but hey guys, if you want that, go to the comments, hit the link, and it'll take you to those online courses. You can pick what works best for you and what do you think you wanna learn first. Thanks so much again. You guys have an awesome day.